Peace to the gods, peace to the earths.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace to the gods, peace to the earths, and all righteous families of the planet. It's your big brother Fahiym, back again, once again, with the god Black Ra Law. You know, back with another little, you know, bill session, you know, with the god or whatever.
Indeed.
You know, they've been having a lot of discussions lately. I've been seeing on, you know, just on Facebook and stuff like that.
All right.
And I said, you know what? Since the M.G.C. network, since this is a teacher-student forum, you know what I'm saying? It's good that we could, you know, sit down and discuss stuff like that, because a lot of people out there watching and they really want to know. So one of the questions that a lot of people been asking is like, and then I think this is a good question to ask the God, because you know what I'm saying? He's nation of gods and earths.
True,
5%er. We're both 5%ers. He's a nation of gods and earth 5%er, so I think he's qualified that I could at least sit down and have this dialogue, you know, with him.
True indeed.
But a lot of people have been asking the question, what is the difference between the two groups of 5%ers, between the 5% nation of gods and earths and the 5% nation of Islam? Is there a difference? What is it?
Well, for one, the first question I asked when somebody asked me about the Muslim gods, I asked, for one, are they righteous? Because you answer that question, are they righteous?
Yeah, that was always the first question.
Yeah, you answer that question, yes, and then I ask the next question about the knowledge equality degree in the 1 through 40. Do they live out that degree? Are they poor righteous teachers? Right? Pretty much after that, I don't really have to ask another question because that makes them 5%.
Right.
You understand? We don't have to debate over who a 5% is if you know your knowledge equality degree in the 1 through 40. You understand? Just because we got different motives, as long as we got the same objective, everything going to be right and exact.
True.
So that's why I feel about the situation.
True.
You understand? I'm pretty sure it's a lot of cultures that call themselves Nawapians or whatever. If you teaching the righteous way,
you gotta be living it.
I know a lot of gods in the nation of gods and earth, and I ask, are they righteous? I could name so many gods that was drug kingpins, and they more savage than the Muslim gods. At least I know when I meet a Muslim god, if he a God that calls himself a Muslim God, I know that God is most likely righteous. You understand? Because I never met a Muslim God that wasn't righteous. But I never met a Muslim that wasn't righteous. You know, I'm not talking about somebody that says I'm Muslim and not practicing the righteous way, not practicing the deen. You understand? I'm talking about somebody who says this and actually living it. So, you know, as far as the difference go, I don't see a hell of a difference. Because the Muslim gods that I build with, they know 120 just like I know 120.
Right.
You understand? Right. They can build on the lessons just like I build on the lessons and actually live it. They got their three forms of wisdom.
Right. When you say they know 120, when you say no, does that mean like memorize? Or
no,
do they
I'm talking about live it. Because anybody, I memorize the national anthem, God. I memorize the national anthem. I'm not living it. You know what I'm saying? No. I'm talking about actually living the righteous way, because when you go, that degree is most profound and most important. When you go to that 16th degree in the 1 through 40, you got to live that degree.
Yeah.
Anybody can recite it.
Yeah.
We know what a 10% or the 85% and the 5% is, but are you living it?
True indeed.
Are these guys teaching it?
True indeed.
You understand?
You know, in our lessons, you know, the question is asked, who is the 5% on this poor part of the planet Earth?
True indeed.
And you know, I know sometimes the lessons kind of vary a little bit in wording, you know, but in the nation of Islam, ours says they are the poor righteous teachers who do not believe in the teachers of the 10%, who are all wise and know who the true and living God is, and that teach that the living God is the Son of Man, Supreme Being, the Black Man of Asia, and teach freedom, justice, and equality to all human families of the planet Earth, otherwise known as civilized people, also Muslims and Muslim sons. So the question I'm going to ask you is, do you think Elijah Muhammad, if someone was to ask him, you know, are you a 5%? What do you think his answer would be, yes or no, according to that definition?
Of course, yes. Right and exact. I mean, he's teaching the righteous way. You understand? Like I said, a lot of people got to go back to the root. Matter of fact, in that degree, it talks about Asia. What is Asia? Asia is the body. You understand? So we all one. Our lives one. Asia is the body. So you can't separate the body. You separating the arm from the leg. The head, you starting to separate the arm, leg, leg, arm, supreme head. You can't separate it.
Good teaching.
You understand? Then it's going to be a division.
Right.
You understand? Right. We got the same lessons. It's just like a Christian. Catholicism, well, we're going to say Baptist and non-denominational. When you ask those, are y'all a Christian? They're going to say, yeah, I'm a Christian.
Yeah.
They're not going to even put the title in front.
Differences, right?
They're going to say, I'm a Christian. Right. What kind of Christian are you? A Baptist. But that's after Christian.
Right.
What kind of Christian are you? I'm non-denominational. What kind of Christian are you? I'm Catholicism. What kind of Christian are you? Episcopal. You understand? So we shouldn't do it either.
Right.
Are you a 5%er? You understand? Yes. I'm Muslim God. Are you a 5%er? Yeah. I'm Nation of God on earth. You understand? Allah is still one. Just like those Christians. They all one. You understand? So we don't need to separate just because we got different motives, the same objectives. The objective is to teach the righteous way. The objective is to be 5%.
Yeah. Basically, at the end of the day, you know, from my understanding is pretty much the message is you know, what we teach in the Nation of Islam or as Muslim gods is that, you know, I know like in the Nation of Gods and Earth, they say the father is the first 5%er. You know, and we say, you know, that's now cipher because just going by this definition, the father was the first one to now begin to, you know, get out to the babies and, you know, but the group or the name of the, you know, who is the 5%? The messenger right there basically gives us everything that a 5%er is supposed to be doing.
Yeah, but
you know, poor righteous teachers, they teach all of the human family, the planet Earth, that, you know, everything right there.
The thing about it, the father, most say the father is the one to propagate the 5% of the degree.
Right.
But
right,
we're not saying the father was the first 5%. No, not right, by a long shot.
Right, right.
But he was the first to propagate
the degree.
5%. Exactly. Right. Because one thing about the father, he knew the root. He never went against the root.
Yeah, good point.
You understand?
Yeah.
He never went against the root. One thing about the father, he always had a final, he always had either a final call or he had what? Missed to the black man in his hand. You can look at a lot of pictures, you still see father with the book. So if he had the book missed to the black man, he's not going against the root. He just propagate that degree to 5%. Even old man Justice, when you see him build and whatnot, you'll see
missed
to the black man. Or you'll see that degree.
Right. And that's crazy because a lot of the firstborn, a lot of the elders, of course, we know, you know, when we look at the, you know, some of the elders, you know, Habika or Habeka, Brother Rasul, you know, Nation of Islam, brother, you know, Muslim. And these are brothers who professed Muslim and God at the same time. You know, of course, the father, you know, himself, Brother Clarence 13X, you know, Abu Shahid, Father Shahid, you know what I'm saying? I mean, all of these brothers had the messenger's teaching deep-rooted in them. So when they gave that to the babies, you know, there was no disconnection there. There was one, you know, when we see a lot of pictures, I see sometimes the God Wakil post pictures of some of the, you know, back in the 60s and the early 70s, and what book are they holding up?
True indeed.
What book they holding
message
up?
Message to the black man.
Message to the black man.
True indeed. Like I said, you can never go against the root, God. Even, like I said, even the Quran and the Bible, and when I talk about these lessons in the books, I'm talking about, like the father said, make sense of the lessons.
Right.
We all got to make sense of the Bible. I can look in the Bible and I can see so much trash in it. If I don't make sense of it,
right,
if I look at it for face value and not be able to draw it up and break it down,
you won't be able to apply it.
Yeah, I can't apply it. And I'd be just as lost as
the average 85%.
Yeah, exactly. So it's the same thing with the lessons. You can't even get a lesson on face value and say, oh, that's what the father meant. That's what the most honorable Elijah Muhammad meant. No, you gotta
manifest
it. Gotta make sense of the lessons.
You know, I remember one of my enlighteners, you know, Nation of Islam, Muslim God, brother, you know what I'm saying, Father Islam Shabazz, you know, one of my elder gods, you know. But I remember one time, you know, he used to always tell me, you know, with the father, that was one of his main things he used to always say when he was in the Nation of Islam, you know, back, you know, in the 50s or whatever, late 50s, early 60s, you know, and he would get into little disputes with other brothers in the mosque or whatever. That was one of his favorite things he used to always say was, let's get the messenger on the line, or let's, I bet you Elijah can tell you what I'm saying is right and exact, or let's call Elijah and let's see what he says about this, or, but it's just, you know, like I said, today, we don't see the message to the black man being utilized no more. We don't see our Savior has arrived being utilized no more. We don't see the fall of America. We don't see How to Eat to Live, book 1 and 2. I told the God, like, when I first met the God back in the days, you know, like, well, not back in the days, but when I first got knowledge of self back in the days, I was telling the God, I only thought I wasn't supposed to eat pork. When I was, you know, just with the Nation of Gods and Earths and studying with them brothers, I just thought that was the only thing we weren't supposed to eat.
True,
but then later on, after reading How to Eat to Live, I'm like, wow, it's a whole, you know, pretty much what black people classify as soul food. Pretty much the messenger is against the majority, you know, from the sweet potatoes to the, you know, butter beans to the black eyed peas to the, you name it.
And that's what I'm cornbread. Saying. You got to make sense of it, just like the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad was on the 1 meal a day. You know, if you are working a labor job or you working out or you're an athlete, you know,
you can't do that.
You kind of got to make sense of it. You need your protein.
Right.
And but my thing is this, God, who am I? It's Blackgod Ra to question another God's godhood. You understand? I don't care what he call himself. If you can show and prove you God, who am I to repudiate your godhood?
Right.
I got to show and prove I'm God. I got to strive to live the righteous way each and every day. So I can't waste time worried about your title.
Right.
What you call it. If you showing, if you walking a straight path or Mooster King or whatever you want to call it, you walking a straight path, don't, I'm not here to knock you off of that.
Right.
You understand? Right. So, I can't question your godhood over a title. The title is small.
Right.
God, my title is small.
Yeah.
It's what surrounds the title.
Right. It's what you do.
You understand? Yeah.
True God, indeed. At the end of the day, is a verb, but it's a verbal noun.
True indeed.
Meaning that you can't say you God and you're not doing nothing. You can't say you God and in the last 5, 10, 15 years, you haven't built nothing.
Indeed.
You can't say, you know, you know, you can't say you follow Islam, like, you know, Minister Farrakhan teaches that Islam is a verbal noun as well, because it's an individual that it implies action.
True indeed.
What are you doing? You know, all atoms we know on a scientific level, if we want to take it off of the theology and bring it to the science, all atoms move. They're in a vibratory state.
Exactly.
If they aren't in a vibratory state, then we say that's something that's considered dead.
See, my thing is, I have no problem, because I'm Nation of God on Earth. I have no problem with somebody calling themselves a Muslim God. I have a problem with somebody wearing the universal flag and not showing and proving they are God. You understand? That's my problem. It's just like I said, if my sister's a Delta, if another female walk around with a Delta jacket or shirt or whatever, she gonna question that. She gonna say, what chapter you on? What line you was on? So I feel by paying my dues, I should be able to do the same thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't care if you're Muslim God, I don't care if you're Nation of Gods on Earth, I don't care who you are. If you're wearing that universal flag,
entertainer, if
you I wanna build with you.
Yeah.
We don't gotta go over lessons. I just wanna build with you.
That's a good point.
And you showing and proving that you God. If I ask you and we build it, I don't even gotta give you no degree.
Right.
Just build with me.
Just build with me.
And show me that you God. We don't gotta build for an hour, we can build for 10 minutes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But
and it don't even have to be what's today's math.
Yeah.
You know, some God's like
some God's
you get that right, okay, he's God. Wow, he's really God. And he the biggest damn devil in the world.
Because I know a lot of people that can quote the mathematics.
Right.
I know a lot of them, God. Mean that. I know Christians that can quote mathematics.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like I'm saying, we got to stop separating what God is. Right. We can't separate. Right. We can't separate it because nothing's going to get. We strong apart, but we powerful together.
Right.
That's why even black people, period.
Right.
And that's what's wrong, man. We always that group, divisions. That group, this group. Mm-hmm. We're worse than a white man. There go that colonialism.
Mm-hmm.
Colonialism among sex.
Right.
Colonialism among religions. Colonialism among conscious community.
Right. Right. got conscious banging, gang banging.
Can't do it.
You know that. You know. Mm-hmm. But that is another important question as well. You know, you mentioned God. Mm-hmm. You know, within the two groups of 5 percenters, you know, how does the 5% in the Nation of Gods and Earth view Allah? You know, we know that Brother Clarence 13X, when we call in the Nation of Islam, Brother Clarence 13X and the brothers in the Nation of Islam who are 5 percenters in the Nation of Islam, we say the Father, you know, but we know that the 5 percenters in the Nation of Gods and Earth should say Allah. So just dealing with that real quick, as far as what the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught about who Allah God is and the Nation of Gods and Earths, you know, expound on that just a little bit, you know, the differences between the two, or if there are any differences.
It's really not different, girl. We, like, in the Nation of God and Earth, we look at the Father, Clarence 13X, as Allah. Mm-hmm. But, yet and still, Clarence 13X, the Father, who, if you saying Clarence 13X, you're not in this nation at all anyway. Mm. Because we, that's the Father. Mm. You understand? So,
in the Nation of Gods and Earths.
Point blank, period.
Okay.
That's the Father. So, the way we see it is, just like the Father said, you God. Mm. So, he wasn't just God. We all was gods. Mm. He was just the Father that brought the lessons. Showed us the righteous way. Showed us who we were. Okay. It's just like, when I see Master Fraud Muhammad, mm-hmm. I look at him as the knowledge.
Okay.
I look at the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad as the wisdom, and I look at the Father Allah as the understanding. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. He understood the lessons, how to teach to us. Mm-hmm. Because he attracted us with the lessons first. He attracted me with the lessons first, even though Master Fraud brought the lessons. Mm-hmm. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, like I said, I knew about the Nation of Islam first, mm-hmm. but the attraction came for me looking at the Rookies League over the NBA. Mm-hmm. Like the guard say, the NBA is chest-to-chest passes. It's kind of fundamental.
Right.
But when you go to the Rookies, it's kind of exciting. You're like, oh, mm-hmm. that's Rakim rapping. That's KRS-One. Mm-hmm. Ooh, that's Poor Righteous Teachers. They kind of draw you in. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. that's what attracted me to it. Like, mm-hmm. oh, they talking some good stuff there. Mm-hmm. Erykah Badu said, I was born underwater with $3.06. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you may laugh, but you did not do your math. So when I was unconscious, when I didn't have knowledge of self, I was like, what?
Yeah.
It's jamming though. Mm-hmm. But she said, I was born underwater. Water is wisdom. Right. Born the black woman underwater with $3. Mm-hmm. That's $306. That's 60. Yeah, you mm-hmm. may laugh, but you did not do your math, your supreme mathematics. Mm-hmm. So that attracted me. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So that would pull me in. Mm. The Father style of freestyling the lessons.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
So
that's self-style.
Yeah, self-style wisdom. Because like I said, you got three forms of wisdom. You got swift wisdom. Mm. You got supreme wisdom, swift wisdom, and self-style wisdom. Mm. The supreme wisdom is the supreme wisdom, the supreme book.
Right, and that's interesting too. That they called it the Father's self-styled wisdom.
Sure, indeed.
You know, that's interesting. I built with a God about that once before, because you know the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, you know, gave us the supreme wisdom, in which from what I understand, when studying with the Nation of Gods and Earths. Mm-hmm. This is where the mathematics and a lot of the lessons, you know, well, really the 120 level, what they call the 120 lessons, mm-hmm. came from, you know, the supreme wisdom. The messenger had the supreme wisdom, but the Father had his own self-styled wisdom.
Sure,
so in other words, I just always looked at that as he had his own self-style of teaching, his own unique way of teaching the messenger's supreme wisdom. You know, a lot of people I know is, this is another thing too, I hear, as far as knowledge, wisdom, and understanding.
Yeah.
You know, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, as far as all of the literature that I've read in the Nation of Islam, the messenger said knowledge, wisdom, understanding, but then there's also parts where the messenger said wisdom, knowledge, understanding.
Yeah.
So he used them interchangeably.
Yeah.
He had a reason for doing that.
Yeah.
But the thing is, a lot of brothers that I've encountered in the Nation of Gods and Earth say that the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad was wrong, or he didn't know what he was saying, so it took the Father to come and... Well, first of all, they don't even know that the messenger said knowledge, wisdom, understanding. They don't even know that he put it in that order to begin with.